I am here for delivering my lecture in International E-Conference on Strategies and Challenges in Higher Education during COVID-19 lockdown period in India with respect to world. The topic of my speech is Coronavirus and its chemistry, soaps, sanitizers and related essential materials. Why does soap work so well on the SARS-CoV-2, the coronavirus and indeed most viruses? Because it is a self-assembled nanoparticle in which the weakest link is the lipid bilayer. The two-part thread about soap, viruses and supramolecular chemistry. Now this is the coronavirus structure which is given by WHO, and here we can clearly see the structure and what is inside the coronavirus. Here three things are there. One is a protein, another is a lipid layer, and inside this there is a gRNA, genome RNA is there. It is very important that it is enveloped by lipid layer. Now I have shown here the internal structure of the coronavirus. See, three types of proteins are there. RNA is also there, and lipid, that is envelope, is there. So it is enveloped in lipid layer. Now chemical reaction of fats and oils, how it is related with corona, that we are going to see. Fats and oils are nothing but lipids, and lipid layer is covered in coronavirus, inside which RNA is there. About virus, we have already seen, that is RNA is there, proteins are there, lipids are there. The RNA is a viral genetic material. It is very similar to DNA. The proteins have several roles, including breaking into the target cell, assist with viral replication, and basically to be a key building blocks in a whole virus structure. Now this is about all we have already explained in previous slide. Now we were talking about fats and oils. Actually lipids are nothing but fats and oils. Fats are solid at room temperature and oils are liquid in room temperature. See, all fats are saturated and oils are unsaturated material. Now what are soaps? Nowadays even on when you watch TVs, previously there was a 10 minutes break, but nowadays there is a 10 seconds break, and now it has changed to 20 seconds break, because 20 seconds are required for washing hands. What are soaps? Soaps are sodium or potassium salts of fatty acids. They are produced from hydrolysis of natural oils or fats, a chemical reaction called sulfonification. Soap is an excellent cleaner which often occurs in the form of solid bars. Chemicals in soap, various chemicals are there, fatty acids, soaps, tallow, palm, other additives are there. Now there is a big history, means soap timeline I have given here, means before Christ, 2800 years soaps are using. Again means there is a 1550 is the history, 1525 is also there. Now, here you can see the various products. Actually, these are chemical products which are brought in the market in various brand name. I am not going to advertise all these things, but I am also telling you about how it is used and how it curbs coronavirus from attacking, or how we keep away from coronavirus. See, here I have given a various materials which are used in home for personal health care products. See, here two things are there. One is a soap and other is alcohol. Soap breaks and alcohol dissolves lipid layer. See, lipid layer means outer part of the coronavirus, which is an envelope that is made up of lipid layer. And for that soap and alcohol is also used. Nowadays it is oftenly people are asked to use these products. One is I have given Listerine. It is actually mouthwash. I am not going to take a name. One another Dettol we see. All this directly sanitizer is there, and aftershave lotion is also there. These are actually alcohol based products. Here more than 60% 70% alcohol is in this products. See, it helps to keep virus away from the disease, pandemic disease. See, Listerine, when we take in mouth, that time it kills the germs, as well as it deactivates the coronavirus. Actually, it is not a live thing, but it is a chemical composition which we have already seen. Listerine is there, Dettol is there, hand sanitizer, is there. After lotion means when we shave in the morning, that time we use a shaving. After shave is nothing but it is a containing more than 90-95% alcohol. And if you take deodorant are used nowadays. See, deodorant are also containing about 90% or more than 70% alcohol. So all these products are containing alcohol. Even hand sanitizer is also containing alcohol, which kills the which deactivates the coronavirus. As I have already told in this lecture, soaps are used. Soaps are breaking the lipid layer, and RNA is becomes open. And when RNA becomes open, then it is not of use. See, use of soaps and alcohol, actually soap is it's a chemical reaction. But in case of alcohol, it dissolves lipid layer. So whenever outer part is dissolved, RNA becomes open. And when it becomes open, it is not of use. And in both the things, this idea is used. See, some toilet soaps we are using. Shaving cream is there, detergents are there, and again hand wash, which I was telling about the hand wash. These are the products. Now, chemical composition of soap we have to see. In next slide, we are going to see this is the structure of the fat. Fat from fat soap is made, and even the outer part of the corona is also made up of lipid, that is nothing but fat. This is the structure of the fat. Now, what are the fatty acids? This is a long chain, long hydrocarbon chain, which is a hydrophilic in nature, and carboxylic group is also attached to end. This is the fatty acid structure. Now, same is thing again repeated, but it contains a phosphate group. And how polar heads are arranged, and how non-polar heads are coming together, there is a hydrophilic nature and it forms in the form of cell membrane, which protects the RNA in a virus. Now again, same structure we are going to see. Glycerol is there, and fatty acids, fatty acids when combined with glycerol, glycerol is having the 3-hydroxy group, and it converts into triglycerol. Now, how soups are made? See, whenever these fatty acids are broken, and glycerol is separated from fatty acids, and when fatty acids react with sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, it becomes a sodium salt of fatty acid, and it is used as a soup. Various type of things are given here: sodium stearate and other soaps are given here. Now, same thing here. It is repeated. Now, this is the structure of the fatty acid, sodium salt of fatty acid. See, hydrophilic, hydrophobic part is given. It's a long nonpolar end, and it is soluble in oil. While the head, that is sodium salt of carboxylic acid, which is a hydrophilic in nature, it is part of the soap. Now, same thing, how it is used and how polar and non-polar heads are there, how it reacts with the dirt and other things, it is given in this picture. Now, disinfectants and liquids, wipe, gel, creams containing alcohol and soap, which we have already talked in earlier speech. Now, instead of viral self assembly is based on weak non-covalent interactions between proteins, RNA and lipid, which we have already seen. Together, these act together like a Velcro. As we know how Velcro works. So, it is a very hard to break up the self-assembled viral particle. Still, we can do it. Now, when the surface is your skin, it is very important. And for awareness, WHO has already given guidelines. Means what things are done and what should not be done. Means one has to use mask, one has to use hand gloves, one has to use various things like soap and sanitizers also. Because skin is very important. The skin is a ideal surface for virus. It is organic, and proteins and acids in dead cells on surface interact with virus through both hydrogen bonds and the fat-like hydrophilic interactions. This, as we have already seen in previous speech, that coronavirus is made up of RNA, protein and a lipid layer. So in dead cells there is a fatty acid, that is a lipid material is there. So it is used by virus, and it helps in copying the virus. So when you touch, say, steel surface with virus particle on it, it will stick to your skin and hence get transferred into your hands. But you are not yet infected. If you touch your face with the virus, can get transferred from your hands and on your face. See, Miss. So let's try washing it off with plain water. It might just work, but water only compacts with the strong glue-like interactions between the skin and virus via hydrogen bonds. The virus is quite sticky and may not budge. Water isn't enough. Soapy water is totally different. Soap contains fat-like substances known as amphipheles, some structurally very similar to the lipids. In the virus membrane, the soap molecules compete with the lipids in the virus membrane. This is more or less how soap also removes normal dirt of the skin. The soap molecules also compete with a lot other non-covalent bonds, which help the proteins, RNA and lipids to stick together. The soap is effectively dissolving the glue that holds the virus together and to that all the water. The soap also outcompetes the interactions between the virus and the skin surface. Soon the virus get detected and fall apart like a house of cards due to combined action of soap and water. The virus is gone. The skin is quite rough and wrinkled, which is why you do need a fair amount of rubbing and soaking to ensure the soap reaches every crack and nanny on the skin surface that could be holding active virus. Alcohol-based products we are using to keep coronavirus away. Soap not handy, alcohol to the rescue. That is, alcohol-based products, which pretty includes all disinfectants and antibacterial products, contain a high percentage alcohol solution, typically 60 to 80% ethanol, sometimes with beta isopropyl as well, and then water plus a bit of soap. Ethanol and other alcohols do not only readily form hydrogen bonds with the virus material, but as a solvent are more lipophilic than water. Hence, alcohol does also dissolve the lipid membrane and disrupt other supramolecular interactions in the virus. Now, you see this picture, various things are used, means total six type of means things are used to kill, used to deactivate the virus. One is a heat directly, it heats and RNA structure is broken. Triton, in this case outer lipid layer is made inactive, broken, that is non-ionic surfactant is used. In case of ethanol, it dissolves the outer part, that is lipid layer. 2-propanol is also used, and in this case the lipid layer is disturbed and RNA, when it comes, it becomes inactive. PVP1 is also same thing, lipid layer is dissolved, and UV light is different from all these things. UV light directly react with RNA, means it is broken, and even though virus remains as it is, but internal part is of not use. This is the very different from other sources. See, RNA is inside, it is a wrinkle set. Capsid is there, envelope, that is yellow colored envelope is there, and glycoproteins are also there. This is very important to know about these things. However, you need a fairly high concentration of the alcohol to get rapid dissolution of virus. See, means one product is there, vodka or whiskey, it's a chemical product actually, and it is used for consuming. Especially vodka is used in cold area, especially Russia and other things. Whiskey is there. Usually it contains 40% ethanol, or sometimes it is 33 or less than that it contains. Will not dissolve the virus as quickly because percentage is less, and as it is less percentage, it is not that much active. Overall, alcohol is not quite as good as soap at the task. As we have already discussed, soap directly interacts, it reacts with the virus, and virus material, that is lipid outer part, it is a fatty acid and it is broken by soap. And alcohol, we know that it dissolves the lipid layer. And in both cases, when outer part is broken or dissolved, when RNA comes out and when it is open, it is not of use, it is inactive. Nearly all antibacterial products contain alcohol and some soap, and this does help killing viruses. But some also include active bacterial killing agents like triclosan. Those, however, do basically nothing to virus. Now, again, we are looking how it is arranged. It's a very fantastic picture in which the fatty lipid layer, fat that is a lipid layer, is arranged. See, lipids are molecules that contains hydrogen, hydrocarbons, and make up the building blocks of the structure and the function of living cells. Example of lipid includes fats, oils, which we have already seen. Certain vitamins are also there, as A, D, E and K. Hormones and most of the cell membranes that is not made up of protein. Here hydrogen bonding is very important. We know that hydrogen bond is not there, then it is not of use. See, one thing is very important. Hydrogen is having a more electropositive charge, and in chemical bonding, in valence bonding, some extra positive charge is remained with hydrogen. Now some elements are there like oxygen, sulfur, phosphorus. These are having electronegative elements, and these are having extra negative charge. Some extra positive charge with hydrogen and some extra negative charge with these elements like nitrogen, sulfur, phosphorus, etc. And there is a formation of hydrogen bonding. For example, if we take water molecule is having, means not one single molecule, but it is an association of molecules. At least four molecules come together and they form an association of molecule. In this case, they exchange the extra positive charge to other molecule, and other molecule also exchange its extra negative charge to other molecule. So in this way, it is working. In the DNA or RNA structure, we know that all the amino acids are having molecules and they are kept as it is, but only due to hydrogen bonding they are linked, and it helps lot in formation of membrane cell and other things. Life is only possible due to hydrogen bonding. Now, what are lipids that we have already previously discussed, but again, there are main types of lipids are there: triglycerides, phospholipids, and steroids and waxes are there. this also falls in the category of lipids, and it can be also washed with the help of soap. Now this is the chemical structure, how it is attached, and classification of lipids we are looking here. And it's a very good, fantastic photo of the lipid, means how the various elements are arranged, the special arrangement we are looking here, and it gives very good idea. Now again, membrane lipid, how it is there, as earlier we have discussed regarding fats and oils. In fats, fatty acid is saturated. In oils, fatty acids are unsaturated. It's a combination of sometimes saturated and unsaturated fatty acids also. That is shown here. I have used various references which are available on the internet, because COVID-19 is a recent, from December 19, it is very much discussed, and it is also what area for students, researchers, teachers, and even administrators, governments also. So the references which I have taken mostly from the internet, and this is the recent one in the month of January, February, up to today. The very important thing is that it has helped me a lot for making this whole lecture, and I am very much thankful to scientists, teachers, researchers, and students who made all information available on the internet and use for educational purpose. I am also thankful to chief patron, Saurav Vijay sir, who has continuously in contact with all government college teachers, and they have acted as a catalyst for us, and he has given guidelines for work from home, and this is the idea of our higher authority, and students who made all information available on internet and use for educational purposes.